write down, is this the last 4-hour class or the last morning class?
Physics.
Write down dimensional analysis.
So there, if you had used time period as 9/10, we'd have got the wrong answer.
You could have got it wrong. But then, even if you get it right, you get zero. Because you have to write whatever you have in terms of whatever you have measured. You're not measuring the time period. You're measuring 100 times the time period. Okay? You have to modify the expression itself.
So if you divide the error by any constant, does it just divide normally? Like if we did what Vikas said, if we did 90/100,
then you have to divide the error also then. 100. Okay? So when you divide the error, you are essentially increasing the accuracy of the instrument. Which is absurd. You can't divide 1 from 100 and then say accuracy is now 1/100. Okay. Understood?
Yeah.
Accuracy remains 1 second. Whether you measure 1 time period, 100 time period, whatever it is. Alright? But mathematically, it may come out to be same answer. It may. But that will be a wrong method. I can devise a question in such a way that if you do like this, you'll get a wrong answer. Okay? Alright. So, dimension analysis. So, at the start of the chapter itself, we have ascertained or we have found out that there are 7 dimensions in this universe. Yes or no? Mass, length, time, quantity, temperature, luminous intensity, and what else?
Amount of substance.
Did I not?
Current.
Okay. So, if there is a derived quantity, all those derived quantities can be written in terms of these dimensions. Now, these fundamental dimensions. Now, the thing is that, suppose, let's say, it doesn't make sense to add mass with the length, right? Kg with 1 meter doesn't make any sense, or meter with time, 1 second with 1 meter doesn't make any sense, okay? This you can understand pretty well when I take the example of the basic quantities itself. But this is true also for the derived quantities. What I am saying is, you can't add velocity with the acceleration. 1 meter per second adding to 2 meter per second square is absurd. Okay? So, when you are adding the two quantities, the dimension should match. That is why when you have that formula, V is equal to U plus AT, you're multiplying A with T, so that meter per second square becomes meter per second. Meter per second square you're multiplying with second, so it becomes meter per second. Then you add. Okay? So we are going to use this property of universe having 7 basic dimensions to do some analysis. And using dimension analysis, you will see that it is a very, very strong concept, because there cannot be any exception to it. No formula can have an exception of whatever I'm saying. That, you know, you can't add two dimensions which are different. Okay? Similarly, when you write force is equal to mass times acceleration, that equation must be correct dimensionally also. Dimension of force should be equal to dimension of mass into dimension of acceleration. Are you getting it? So, when you are equating, their dimensions must be equal. Right? So, this is what we are trying to do in the analysis of the dimension. Okay? So, before we get into the dimension analysis, we'll first write down the basic things that are required us to keep in our mind to do the analysis. Okay, write it down. Okay, so an equation can be dimensionally correct but may not be true. What do I mean when I say this?
The dimensions might match.
Dimensions may match.
Yeah.
But actually that equation has no meaning to it.
Yeah.
Okay, that can happen. But the reverse can never happen. Equation which is not dimensionally correct can never be true. Okay? Fine? So, the implication of this itself is that you write down two physical quantities cannot be added or subtracted if their dimensions are not same. Two physical quantities cannot be added whose dimensions are different. Okay? Cannot be added or subtracted, both. Okay? Okay? Now when we write the dimension of anything, okay? When we write dimension of anything, for example, let's say dimension of speed. Unit is meter per second. The way we write dimension is this. We take a square bracket like this. Okay? And, you know, ideally we should write seven dimensions over here. The universe has seven dimensions. But since in our class 11th, entire 11th is about more or less mechanics itself. So we're using only the dimensions which are defining the mechanics. Which are what? Mass, length and time only. Okay? But it doesn't matter, it doesn't mean that only three dimensions you have to write. Suppose I bring in, you know, magnetism or current, then you have to use ampere also. Okay? But right now we just need three dimensions, which are mass, length and time. Okay? So if you know that the speed is a division of meter and second like this, you can write its dimension as mass to the power 0. It has no dimension of mass. Okay? Length to the power 1 and time to the power minus 1. So this is the dimension of the speed. You can treat like universe has 7 coordinate axes. One coordinate axis for mass, other coordinate axis for length, other coordinate axis for time, like the 7 coordinates are there. So the speed lies in this L1 T minus 1 coordinate. Okay? You can add only along that coordinate if something lies. Okay? So this is the dimension of speed. Similarly, you know, I have given you a simple example, speed. I want you to write down dimension of these things. Please write it down. These things quickly write down.
So what is here?
Gravitational potential energy. KE is kinetic energy. Done?
Yeah.
Acceleration will be what dimension?
Length and
time. M 0 L 1 T minus 2. Yes or no?
Yeah.
What about force? Dimension of force is?
M1 L1 T minus 2.
Multiply mass with it. It will be
M1
L1 T minus 2. Kinetic energy is half mv square.
M1 L2 T minus 2.
M1
L2
T
minus
2. What about gravitational potential energy? Mgh.
Mgh.
No, yeah. Sir, it's T minus 1.
It's T minus 1?
No, sir.
It's T minus 1.
Next one is minus 1.
Yeah.
No, 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 it's
no.
M1,
no,
L2,
minus
2,
sir.
It'll be minus 2.
Minus 2.
Minus
2. You can check, you know.
Energy.
They have
the energy is MGH. So this is dimension of MGH is equal to dimension of mass into dimension of G into dimension of H. Dimension of mass is M. Dimension of G is acceleration. LT minus 2. Dimension of H is L. When you multiply it becomes L square. Fine. Okay. Now we know that one energy can get converted into another form of energy. We know this or not? Okay,
so all of
the units must be same.
Yeah.
All the energies have this unit. Does not matter what kind of energy we are talking about. Okay, it doesn't matter. Whether it's kinetic energy, potential energy, electrostatic energy, magnetic energy, whatever crap you can think of, all has same dimension. All kinds of forces will have the same dimension. Similarly. Because you are adding and subtracting forces. Okay? Now, if I know already, if I know that, you know, if I know that some variable depends on few things. We'll talk about it a little later. First, let us go slow. For example, let's take this one. S equal to ut plus half at square. Now tell me, does it make a dimension sense? Dimensionally, does it make sense?
Yeah.
Yeah.
If it is making sense, then what should happen? Dimension of length should be equal to dimension of what?
Ut
and at square dimension should also be ut's dimension, because you're adding these two. If you're adding, their dimension should be same, and you're equating, so their both the dimensions should be equal to this also. Dimension of ut is length.
Yeah.
Dimension of a into t square is also length.
Yeah.
Meter per second square into second square. Okay. So if suppose if I know that the time period of pendulum, okay, write down a question. Time period of pendulum. Time period of pendulum is found to be depends, basically I'm trying to say that time period depends on length and acceleration due to gravity g. Okay, it is found to be dependent on length of the pendulum and acceleration due to gravity. Okay, now using dimension analysis, can you derive the formula? Okay, now try to do it yourself. I can tell you, once I tell you, it becomes very straightforward. Can you think and come out with the expression? Time period depends on length and g.
That's s.
Is t proportional to length? That is not given, but it depends on length. It could be length to the power a and g to the power b. Try doing it.
I got it.
Yes, sir. Got it.
This gives you seconds.
But not like this. I mean, although you got it correct, what if you don't know it is root L by G?
No, I got this because I wanted to get
root L by
cancel. G. No, I wanted to get it in terms of seconds.
Yeah, plus, it's a little hard to do it since we got the formula before.
Okay, see, you can say, I want you to do it the way it is generic, because the formula may be very complicated. You may not be able to visualize that, you know, L by G and the root of that is second dimension. Are you getting it? There should be a generic way to do it. Alright? T depends on length. So let's say T is proportional to length to the power A. Okay? And t also is proportional to, let's say, g to the power b. Okay? So t should be equal to some constant k times n to the power a to g to the power b. Understood? Yes or no?
Yes.
Constant has usually no dimension. We are assuming that this constant has zero dimension. Okay? Now this is the equation. Can you write a dimensional equation?
Yes.
Dimension of t is? M0 L0 T1. This is dimension of T. This should be equal to dimension of K multiplied by dimension of L to the power A multiplied by dimension of G to the power B. Getting it? Now dimension of K is what? Nothing. Dimension of L is L. Dimension of G is?
L by 2.
So this is dimension of L is L to the power A. This is L T minus, I am ignoring anything having power 0. So here I have written M to the power 0, L to the power 0, but there I have not written M. Okay. So this is equal to M0 L to the power what? A plus B. And t to the power minus 2b. Getting it?
Minus 2b.
So minus 2b should be equal to 1. So b will be equal to minus half. So if you equate these two, your minus 2b should be equal to 1. So from here, b will be equal to 1 minus 1 by 2. And A should be what? A plus B should be 0. So A should be equal to plus 1 by 2. Now come back here. T will be equal to K into L to the power 1 by 2 and G to the power minus 1 by 2. So it becomes T equal to K times root L by G. Understood? So this method you can use to derive any formula if you know on what physical parameter your expression should depend on. Are you getting it? If you know that force should depend on mass and force should depend on acceleration, if you have decided on the dimension of force, you'll get the value of, you'll get an expression how it is. This dimensionlessness may not give you the value of constant. That you can find experimentally. Getting it? Right? So this is a very powerful method to derive an expression. Okay? So when you put a equal to half and b equal to minus half, you'll get t is equal to k times l to the power half g to the power minus half. So this will be equal to k under root l by g. And experimentally you can find out the value of k is 2 pi. Okay. So if there is a question in let's say JEE Advanced or JEE Mains, most probably it will be on dimensional analysis only. And good thing, it's a straightforward topic. Alright. So that's it for today.
So there, could you give us another one of these type of questions?
I'll give you homework. Give me the book. Good that you reminded me. Homework. Book. Physics. Centum book. Physics centum. All of you have that book, right?
Yes.
No, I just saw
that. How many times you collect the book?
No, I.
Okay. All of you, please note down. Units and dimensions. See, there is a section. Page 3.19. page 3.19, there is a section of JEE Mains. It is written JEE Mains. Okay? You have to complete that exercise. Okay? Now, at times you will see that in a question it will be written as significant figure, significant digit. So whenever you see that phrase in the question, you leave it. That we'll be doing next class. Only significant figures we have not done yet. Okay? Apart from, we have done 99% of the chapter. Understood? So this is, stop talking. Question number 1 to 40. These are objective questions. One question will take hardly 2 minutes. So 40 into 2, 1 hour, 20 minutes. So you have 1 week, 168 hours. So 1 hour, 20 minutes. Okay, for JEE Mains. And if you are targeting JEE Advanced, if that is your target, complete the book.
So this is book 1, right?
Yeah. Module 1. Those who are targeting JEE Advanced, please complete the book.
Complete module 1 by next week.
Not module 1, book. Complete the book as in complete the
chapters.
Question. You can do that. Let's see. Okay. So those who are targeting JEE Advanced, there is no limit. Even if we have not done significant figures, struggle a little bit. That struggle is your learning. If you don't struggle, if you directly look at the solution, although solution is not available right now, neither with me. Okay? So if you struggle, that is your learning. If you're not struggling, you're not learning anything. Remember that.